So here lately, I've been accused of coping, because I guess coping is considered a bad thing nowadays. Pretty fucked up, huh? Nobodies, it's me here once again, here with my co-host, Mr. Nobody. Today in this video, I'm gonna be talking about coping. Because I've had some people accuse me of coping in my comment section here lately. You see, over the last few years, I guess, coping has become sort of like an insult online. Now, I'm getting to be an old man. I'm almost in my 40s, so I don't really pay too much attention to internet jargon. But from what I see, pretty much anybody who's in a what many would consider a bad situation, but tries to look on the bright side of it, pretty much anyone who does that is considered coping, like it's a bad thing. Now, if you go on Google and you look up the definition of coping, all coping is effectively dealing with a difficult situation. Okay, so what's wrong with that? A lot of people would see the situation I'm in and see that as a difficult situation. So I'm just trying to deal with it effectively. What's wrong with that? Why is that considered an insult? I mean, I don't know. I just don't see why that's considered a bad thing. Now, to be fair, I am coping with something, and it's not what you think it is, but I'm coping with a very difficult situation right now. I am coping with a situation. I have bird head. That's right, I am coping with bird head. It's a very difficult thing to cope with. I mean, I can't wear hats. I gotta listen to constant screeching all the time. And the worst part is and he sings over me too. Do you have any idea how hard it is living with Birdhead? Oh, you would say that, wouldn't you? And the worst part is, sometimes I wake up with my head covered in shit. Yeah, no thanks to you. But it's okay though. I've got shampoo. Actually, this is a bottle of Sweet Baby Ray's hot sauce. But it'll do. Dusty, do you think I'm coping? Is that a yes? I was watching an interview with Michael J. Fox not too long ago. I mean, obviously Michael J. Fox has Parkinson's disease and it's advanced pretty far. And but he doesn't sit around and feel sorry for himself all day. He tries to have a positive outlook on life and have a sense of humor. I mean, obviously he doesn't want to have Parkinson's disease. I'm sure he'd rather not have it, but I mean, that's the situation he's in, so he just tries to, live his life the best he can with what he's got. But I'm sure a lot of like these incel types would be like, "Oh, Michael J. Fox, you're coping. You're coping. Secretly, deep down, you're just mad because every can of Coke you drink out of turns flat. Secretly, deep down, you're just mad that you can't stop dancing like a maniac. You're coping, Michael J. Fox." It's like, no, maybe some people just want to look on the bright side of life. Maybe some people just want to enjoy life despite the negative situations they find themselves in. I get people accusing me of coping with like my social awkwardness and my lack of romantic success and my lack of sexual success. I've had a lot of these like incel types come in my comment section like, "Oh, you're coping. You're just trying to be like a blue pill normie." And these are the same assholes who go on like incel forums and bitch about how women don't want to fuck them because they're not 6'10" and they don't make $80 million a year. As if that's not a cope. But me just trying to look on the bright side of my situation, that's coping. That's a bad thing. I don't get it. See, here's the thing. Ever since I started coping, my life's been a lot better. I've had to wear significantly less adult diapers to bed. I've traveled a lot more. I've been to Vegas and like, all these other cool places. I've got to meet some new people. I I got to go to some cool concert. I got to see the Rolling Stones. I got to see Pearl Jam. And, you know, I've had a pretty good, solid outlook on life. So, folks, if this is coping, let me tell you, I fucking love coping. Coping is awesome. Because before I started coping, I felt like shit pretty much 24/7, 365. But now, hey, this coping shit is pretty awesome. I love coping. In fact, I'm going to start coping some more. In fact, I'm going to cope so much that Christopher Nolan is going to make a movie about me. And it's going to be a sequel to his hit movie Oppenheimer. It's going to be a sequel to Oppenheimer, a movie about me called Copenheimer. It's going to be about how I like draw big bombs of cope everywhere I go. And the actor who's going to play me in Copenheimer is going to be, who else? Dwayne Johnson. That's right. I'm going to cope so much that Christopher Nolan is going to make a movie about me where I'm being played by Dwayne Johnson. Now, I mean, we pretty much look exactly alike. I mean, the only difference is he's a muscular, heavily tattooed, bald Samoan guy. But, I mean, you put a 90s lesbian blonde wig on this dude and some glasses. I mean, the resemblance is going to be uncanny. But yeah, I mean, coping, it's awesome. I love it. My life has gotten so much better since I started doing it. And I highly recommend doing it. And that's pretty much all I got to say in this video. Keep it cringy, everybody.